Karen Hansen. It's Mrs. Carrigan.
And Mrs. Garrett.
And we're here today to talk to you about course selection. Believe it or not, it's that time of year again. So to get started, you should have in front of you your course selection sheet. There'll be some directions on there for you. Also, if you're interested in the program of studies, it is available online. We have limited copies available in the office. But again, look online, and that's the best way to find that. So what about the schedule this year? We don't expect that there'll be any changes. The schedule will stay 7 periods. 5 periods will meet each day. Major academic classes will be full year, and electives will be half year. If you hope to attend college, one of the most important things that we want you to do when you're planning your schedule is to find balance. I can't stress that enough. Find balance. We want to make sure that you're not overwhelmed, that you're not too stressed, and that you really are feeling comfortable with the level of classes that you're taking. That being said, you do want to take the highest level of courses that you can handle without being overstressed or overwhelmed. Over the course of your 4 years, you want to challenge yourself when you can with extra math, science, social studies, and foreign language classes. And it is important to do your best. Colleges will look at all grades from all years. There are lots of colleges out there. You certainly can get into college with taking academic level classes. But again, if you want to challenge yourself, we encourage you to take the highest level that you can handle as long as you can find balance.
Students are expected to take 3 computer classes over the course of the 4 years here. And you guys have a wealth of courses to choose from. When you look at your electives, please read the course description. And here is a listing of all of the computer classes that are offered here, where you get technology credit.
And you can see that we've mentioned or have listed financial literacy in red, and that's because it is becoming a graduation requirement. So if you are a current freshman, that will be scheduled for you in your junior year. Juniors and seniors, if you haven't taken that class, we encourage you to take it next year. It's a great class for getting ready for life.
So when choosing classes, you really need to be thoughtful about this. You want to check for prerequisite courses. So for just as an example, if you want to take Marine Biology 2, obviously you need to have taken Marine Biology 1. Computer Graphics 2, obviously you're going to need to take Computer Graphics 1. But some of the courses are tricky. You need to really read the description to make sure that you have taken the prerequisite course. Also check to see what grade level the course is. Some of them are 9 through 12. Some of them are only for juniors and seniors. Please check. Very importantly, if you choose an elective class, the expectation is that you will take that class. So again, read the description, make sure that this is what you would like to take, not what your best friend wants you to take, and you will be scheduled for that class. Changes will only be made by the school counseling staff if there's an error in the course scheduling. What's happening now is teachers have been conferring with you about your choices for next year and putting in major academic classes. So that has been taking place over the last week. That will end soon. And your job, because the teachers have now done theirs, your job is to choose a gym class for next year and then your elective courses. Friday, March 6th is when Infinite Campus will be open for you to enter your PE and your electives for next year. And you have a full week to do that. So next Friday, 13th, is the last day that you can add. If you have any questions, you don't agree with the course level or recommendations, you can certainly speak with your school counselor. Deadlines are really important because there's a lot of steps that have to be taken in the process of course selection. So you must enter all of your course selections for electives and that PE class no later than Friday, March 13th, which is next week. And this is important. If you don't meet the deadline, classes will be chosen for you. And no, we don't want to have to choose classes for you. We want you to choose electives that you would really like. So please meet the deadline.
Okay, so the first step is for you to go to your Infinite Campus account and log in there. Once you log in, you will see that on the bottom of the screen on the left-hand side, you will see more. And you're going to click on more, and then up comes another screen, and it will say course registration. And we want you to click on that. And then we want you to look for WHS 2021. From here, when you're ready to put a course in, the easiest thing to do is to search by course number. So for instance, in this slide, you see that we've put in class number 8130, that's astronomy. Put the number in, hit the blue button, and then you will find another screen that comes up that asks you if you'd like to add that course. And if you do, you're going to hit request, and then that course will become part of your course selection. So again, log in, go to more, find course registration, click on WH2021, and then add your electives and enter by course number. That's the easiest way to do it. Hit the at sign and then hit request this course.
Okay, so most important, you should choose 14 units or 28 credits so that you don't have too few courses or too many courses. Again, 14 units or 28 credits. And as you're working on this, this will become very clear. Also, because sometimes when you choose an elective, it's either full, perhaps it's not the right course for you because you're a sophomore and you chose a junior class, or it doesn't fit into your schedule given some of the classes that you major classes that you're taking. We recommend that you give us some alternates. So as we're working on your schedules, we know that if we can't put you in your first choice elective, there are others to choose from. So we recommend adding 5 electives as alternates.
So remember, major academic course requests will be submitted by your teachers. Once academic classes are in there, we want you to go in and add your PE and your elective classes until you've requested 14 units or 28 credits. Once you've reached 14 units or 28 credits, please choose an additional 5 classes as alternate choices. And your counselor will consider your alternate choices if the classes you want are full or unavailable. So just to review quickly, make sure you've got those 14 units or 28 credits plus some alternate backups. Challenge yourself with the highest level of classes you can handle as long as you have balance. Again, that keyword is balance. Pick classes with graduation requirements in mind. Confer with your parents and your teachers and meet all the deadlines for entering your course requests. And remember that a good job on the course selection process now is your best chance for a great schedule in August. Good luck with the process. If you have any questions, please be sure to stop by your school counseling office and speak with your counselor.